this is Angie. Today I'm going to show you my card creations that I made from the June 2016 Paper Pumpkin Kit from Stampin' Up. This is the picture of the June kit, and it has some great striped card bases with matching envelopes. And for this month, you will be making cute little banners that attach onto the card bases that you can use for any kind of occasion. The stamp kit has for birthday, shower, graduations, celebrations, and anniversaries. So it's a pretty versatile kit this month. So I made one of the cards with the banner, and what I did for mine is I tied mine onto the card base. So as you untie it and you pull the banner off the card, you will have your happy birthday banner where that can be seen, and then they can open up the card to read the sentiment. But since this kit had some great washi tape and a lot of sequins, well, you can't help but make a shaker card. So I made two shaker cards with the rest of my card bases. The first one is this one, where I just used a rectangle die to make the window. And I had one piece of acetate left in my stash. So I made the traditional shaker card where you attach the acetate to the opening, used foam squares on the back, filled it with sequins, and then glued another panel on the top to hold everything all together. Now this happy is from last month's paper pumpkin kit, but I happen to have some extra ones because I did different cards last month too. But so I used it on here because I thought the mint macaron went perfect with this tip-top taupe color that's in there. So I just made this a happy birthday card, and where the notches were for the to tie the banner for the original card, I just went ahead and used some of the embroidery floss just to add a little bit of extra up there. Now in the kit, you get a lot of extra gold lettering, so you definitely could just spell out happy on here with the gold lettering. That will look just as good. But that's my first shaker card. Here's another shaker card that I made using a circle, and I also used this from last month's kit. And I did the same thing with the twine up here. But what I wanted to show you, which was really cool, is since I ran out of acetate and wasn't able to get any, I happened to be in Target, and I found in the dollar bins in the front, in the teacher theme section, they had these adhesive square label pockets. Now, originally, they're, you know, to take off and put little labels in there, like with probably students' names and whatever, to put onto bins and whatever for storage. And I may end up using those for some of my storage bins, but I bought them. They're $3. I bought them. There's 20 of them in here, and realized that these would be great shaker pockets. So they have the opening at the top, and it's great see-through. It's real clear plastic. And so what I did is I just filled all my sequins in here and then sealed the top really well. And then when I put it in my card, I used adhesive around to attach it to the back of the card. And then I took off the backing, and then I could put my back of my card on there and use more adhesive and just put it all together so you wouldn't see the workings of the card. And it works out pretty good. The sequins don't move really well, but they do move. So I think that was a go with that one. So if you happen to be by Target and you happen to see these would be quick, easy shaker cards. If you have the square die or the circle dies or whatever, you could definitely do that real easy. And a lot less foam tape. So that was my, my third card. My fourth card is I used the stamp set, more of the things in the stamp set, to make this type of confetti pattern. I used mint macaron, tip-top taupe. I used espresso, early espresso, for the sentiment so it would stand out a little bit more. And then I used the new in-color flirty flamingo for more of the dots, because that seemed to match the confetti really well. And then I just added a couple little pieces of confetti on there. So what I did is I on that card panel, I attached it to mint macaron, to another whisper white, and then I attached it onto the card base with foam dots to give it a little bit of dimension. And then from my stash, I had some mint macaron baker's twine, and so I just finished off the card there. The next card is just a simple birthday card that I thought would be fun for summer. There's so much nautical themes and stuff out there right now. So I used our star embossing folder to emboss the front panel of the card. And then again, I used the stamp set here with the Early Espresso Mint Macaron to do this little sentiment. This little cake is from the stamp set from last month's Paper Pumpkin. So that is not with this stamp set, it's from last month. But you could use anything from your stash here to put a little symbol in there. You could use another little star or something like that. And then for my stash, I found some other matching paper that I just made these little banners. I used some of the washi tape that's new to the catalog from the Affectionately Yours Designer Series paper line. And then I just added a little star paper clip here that I had in my stash, along with Mint Macaron Baker's Twine. And this card I flipped so that the notches are on the bottom so I could put the Baker's Twine on the bottom of the card. And then my last card, I tried to do something a little bit different. I just used a panel of that striped card, and I embossed it with the heart. I don't know if you can see it. I probably should hold up here so you can see it. The heart embossing folder. Let me just show you this one real quick with the stars. You can see what the stars look like. But this one I did the hearts, and then I stamped my sentiment on vellum and used gold and did gold emboss. And then I used one of the new in colors, the Peekaboo Peach, to make a heart from heart, my heart dies. I used a little bit of the washi tape that came in the kit, and I'll show that to you. It has like the tip top taupe and some gold and a little bit of peach, which is a perfect match to the Peekaboo Peach. So I used that on there and layered those together, and then I just added a little bit of ribbon just to kind of make it a little bit more dressy, a little bit more sweet for a special wedding anniversary. And then this one I put on tip-top taupe cardstock for the card base. So these are my five different cards that I made from the June 2016 Paper Pumpkin Kit. Of course, you don't have to do this. When you get your kit, you can make them all the same, but I thought I would give you some ideas of some things you could make with items that you may have in your stash, just to kind of add to your card stash for the month. So thank you so much for watching, and hey, if you don't have a Stampin' Up! Demonstrator yet in your life, I would love for you to check the link below in the description below and check out my Stampin' Up! Store. I would really appreciate it. And also, if you have any questions on any Stampin' Up! Products, please put them in the comments below, and I'll be glad to get back with you as soon as I can. Again, thanks for watching, and we'll see you again soon.